really bitter.
Yeah.
Stand it. Yeah.
But taking big roots like this, similar to what I described with the dandelion. You'd wash them off, cut them up into little pieces, roast them, and then grind them. And this will be like, it'll be darker than coffee. It'll be like jet black and really like, looks like oil. But it has a good flavor, not exactly like coffee, but maybe even stronger than coffee. And it's really, 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 really
That's
good.
How I describe it, stronger than coffee.
It's a little different. You know, I don't know if it's stronger,
I don't know if I'd want to get a regular diet of drinking that stuff.
No,
the way
probably not good
straight up, but if you get those mixes of coffee and chicory,
I imagine it's like acidic. It has a bite to it, you know. So I use creamer and stuff in it, just like I do for my own. But this is a plant that I don't think you rarely see anywhere that's not like along a road. It's pretty much just along every road everywhere.
And they actually tell you that you're not supposed to buy that plant and grow it, apparently.
Yeah.
And why would you need to buy it? It's everywhere.
It was considered invasive and stuff like that, yeah. Down south, they actually grow it and they mix it in coffee and stuff. I think in England they do. That's where it's from. But, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Easy. There's nothing else like it. It can be kind of prickly when it's in certain stages, too, these bottom leaves.
Oh, there's another one you could have talked about, but now they're kind of overgrown now, and that's the Japanese knotweed.
I haven't done that yet.
Yeah. Apparently, if you get that when it's young, you can eat it like asparagus. Another one of those plants.
Yeah. So if you come to a place where you know where it is, like here.
Oh, yeah, there's no shortage of it down here.
You know that's it coming up.
One thing I've been wanting to try, in the one edible wild plant book that I have, is apparently you can go out and, you ever hear, you know what greenbrier is?
Yeah,
apparently you can dig up the roots, dry them, cut them up, and you can grind them up and apparently make a wild sarsaparilla.
That sounds like fun.
I've been dying to try that.
Wading through greenbrier and digging this up. Come out bloody.
Yeah.
The raspberry teas with the leaves, is the leaves the same time they're barren? Berries, or?
Yeah, that's around the time that I've done it.
Okay, and then you just pull the leaf off and leave it dry?
I guess I cut a couple stems and hung them up, and then when they're crispy, I just kind of ground up.
You put the plastic cover on yours, didn't you? That
but
window.
I just ground up the stuff. And
I went and took mine off like an idiot.
No, this is the one. I added it from, it was, I think Easter rabbit or something.
A high content of berries actually. I don't think it's like dangerous.
I think mine originally came with the plastic and I took it off.
Like you said, mine are, I have more berries in my flowers than I do flowers because the birds.
Look at how clear this plate is.
Well, they're going to stay green because
with my camera, mine has a coating on the back of it.
Last year and this year I did that.
It's supposed to be a touch screen and it's starting to come off.
I cut some stems and I didn't cut enough to make a whole batch.
Smart to leave it on. I should have left one.
Well, this is just from like Easter candy.
Looks like they're going to do a beekeeping thing here now.
This is from a plastic window on.
I don't think it tastes exactly like raspberries, but it has a trim though.
Hey, if you look hard enough, you can find one of those things.
Many ways a skinny cat.
Yeah. I guess it totally depends on the plant. That's the other one I was saying.
There's one there display package, you want that hard or fast.
And there's other ones that, basically the other ones like the New Jersey tea, like it just wouldn't taste like anything. Like you can nibble on the leaf and it doesn't taste like anything. Drying it maybe gets rid of the water and concentrates the flavor or something, I don't know.
Yeah, because I like flavored tea.